Hi students, in the last video I have covered the chemical properties of amines like alkylation, acylation, benzoylation, carbylamine reaction as well as a reaction with nitrous acid. In today's class, that is lecture number 7, we will discuss about the reaction of amines with aryl sulfonyl chloride. Nothing but benzene sulfonyl chloride. First, we will discuss about its structure. Its structure is like this, benzene ring of course. Benzene ring and S double bond O Cl is nothing but benzene sulfonyl chloride, nothing but aryl sulfonyl chloride, and its another name is Hinzberg reagent. Hinzberg reagent, that's why it is also called as a Hinzberg test. Right, now the advantage of that this test is here, amines are having three types, primary amines, secondary amines as well as tertiary amines. Primary amines will give one type of a test with Hinzberg reagent, secondary amines will give some different type test with Hinzberg test, and tertiary amines will give different types. Now we will discuss all three types of amines reactions with Hinzberg reagent. This is Hinzberg structure, nothing but benzene sulfonyl chloride, nothing but aryl sulfonyl chloride. Now we will discuss one by one all the reactions of like primary amines as well as secondary amines and tertiary amines one by one. First we will go to primary amines with Hinzberg reagent. Directly I will give you an example. I will take C2H5NH2 ethyl amine. I have taken ethyl amine, of course nitrogen is having a lone pair on it. Ethyl amine, which is the primary amine, is reacting with the Hinzberg, nothing but aryl sulfonyl chloride. I can write like this, C6H5, yes, double bond O Cl. Then here a lone pair is coming in attacking on sulfur, then immediately Cl minus is eliminating a minus Cl minus. Now between nitrogen and the sulfur, a new bond is forming. That's why you will get an intermediate compound C2H5 and N, of course, hydrogen and hydrogen. HH will write as it is. Now nitrogen is directly connected with the sulfur. That's why bond sulfur already having two double bonds. And then Cl minus eliminated, but the sulfur is connected with the C6H5. We write C6H5, but still it is not completed because nitrogen has given electron pair. Because of that reason, nitrogen is getting a plus charge. When intermediate compound is obtained, then immediately because of a positive charge of nitrogen, its electronegativity is increasing. Because of that, either this bond or this bond pair is taking towards itself. Bond pair is taking, that's why H eliminated without electron, nothing but H plus. From here Cl minus eliminating, from there H plus, nothing but overall HCl is eliminating in this reaction. Therefore I'll write here minus H plus. After elimination of H plus, the obtained compound is like this, C2H5 bond, here nitrogen and of course hydrogen remains as it is. Now this bond pair is turned as a lone pair, single bond, yes, double bond O, C6H5 is left. Now what is its IUPAC name? Very simple, N ethyl for nitrogen, N ethyl benzene sulfonamide. N ethyl benzene sulfonamide is obtained when primary amine is reacting with the benzene sulfonyl chloride, nothing but Hinzberg reagent. Okay. If you observe the product, here one important thing is there that we'll discuss now. See here nitrogen is connected with hydrogen. Nitrogen is connected with hydrogen, and of course, nitrogen is connected with the SO2 group, which is a strong electron withdrawing group. Means here nitrogen is connected with electron withdrawing group. Because of that reason, then this hydrogen this hydrogen can easily eliminate as a proton. Means it is acidic hydrogen. This hydrogen is acidic hydrogen because hydrogen attached to nitrogen is connected with a strong electron withdrawing group. That's why it is acidic hydrogen. Then because of presence of acidic hydrogen in this compound, then immediately this compound is reacting or soluble in potassium hydroxide base. Because of acidic hydrogen, it is reacting with base. I'll repeat. Because of acidic hydrogen, it is reacting with the base. After reaction with the base, we'll write this. After reaction with the base, let's see what happens. This H eliminated without electron. H plus. H plus. And here OH minus. H plus OH minus eliminated as water. Then the obtained structure is like this. C2H5 nitrogen. C2H5N. N is having minus charge because this bond pair is turned. That's why it is a negative charge. And a bond, yes, double bond O, C6H5, H5. Then if you want, you can keep bracket or without bracket also we can write. That is, here we write K plus. It is a salt. You are getting a salt. I'll repeat. Here, acidic hydrogen is present. Because of acidic hydrogen, it is soluble in alkali, that is KOH. Because of that reason, we will get finally salt is forming when primary amine is reacting with benzene sulfonyl chloride. That's why, overall, we'll see once again, when primary amine reacts with benzene sulfonyl chloride, we are getting one intermediate compound. From this intermediate compound, H plus is eliminating. Of course, H plus Cl minus overall HCl eliminated. Then we will get N-ethyl benzene sulfonamide, and this N-ethyl benzene sulfonamide is having acidic hydrogen. Because of acidic hydrogen, it is a soluble in alkali, and after that reaction, we will get a salt. This is a salt formation. Okay, then we'll go to secondary amine reaction with the Hinzberg reagent. Let's see what happens. Same reaction, absolutely. Now here I am just changing secondary amine. Here this hydrogen I have replaced with the ethyl group. It's of course secondary amine. Its name is a diethyl amine. Diethyl amine is common name, or IUPAC name is N-ethyl ethanamine. And this secondary amine is reacting with the benzene sulfonyl chloride. Again we will get one intermediate compound. In that also one hydrogen I am just changing, guys, C2H5. When this amine is reacted with the benzene sulfonyl chloride, we will get this intermediate compound. And from that intermediate compound also same H plus eliminated without electron. H plus. After that we will get this compound, and here hydrogen is not there. Instead of hydrogen, we will write C2H5 only. And its name is N, diethyl, because this ethyl is attached to nitrogen, this ethyl is also attached to nitrogen. N diethyl benzene sulfonamide. N diethyl benzene sulfonamide is obtained when secondary amine is reacted with the benzene sulfonyl chloride. Now, if you observe this structure, here no acidic hydrogen. Acidic hydrogen is not existing. Because of absence of acidic hydrogen, it is not soluble in alkali. No more salt formation with secondary amines. With the primary amine, salt formation is taking place. With the secondary amine, salt formation is not taking place because there is no acidic hydrogen involving here. That's it. Therefore, its name is N diethyl benzene sulfonamide. Okay. Then primary amines are forming salt, secondary amines are not forming salt. Like that, primary secondary amines we can distinguish. Then we'll go to tertiary amines. Tertiary amines purpose, what I am doing now? This hydrogen also replaced with the ethyl group only. Then If you take a tertiary amines are not at all, because of absence of hydrogen as well as bulky groups. Because of absence of hydrogen as well as presence of bulky groups, tertiary amines are not at all reacted with the Hinzberg reagent. That means no reaction with the tertiary amines, remember. No reaction at all with tertiary amines. That's why with the help of Hinzberg test, we can distinguish primary, secondary, tertiary amines like this. Primary amines reacts and we are getting N-ethyl benzene sulfonamide. And because of presence of acidic hydrogen in this compound, N-ethyl benzene sulfonamide, it is a soluble in alkali and will get a salt. When salt formation occurs, we can say that it is absolutely primary amine. Suppose if it is a secondary amine, then what is the final compound? NN diethyl. Or we can write NN, okay. NN diethyl benzene sulfonamide. Here no acidic hydrogen is present here. Because of absence of acidic hydrogen, it is not reacting with potassium hydroxide. No salt formation, that's it. Then we'll go to tertiary amine. Tertiary amine not at all reacting with Hinzberg reagent. That's why with the help of Hinzberg test, we can distinguish primary, secondary, tertiary amines like this very easily. Okay. Then here one more important point, that is, which reagent we have used here? We have used here benzene sulfonyl chloride. Nothing but Hinzberg reagent we have used. But nowadays, instead of this benzene sulfonyl chloride, we are using this compound. Its name is paratolin sulfonyl chloride. Paratolin sulfonyl chloride or paramethyl benzene sulfonyl chloride. Its another name is tosyl chloride we are using nowadays. These days we are using tosyl chloride. Then why tosyl chloride we are using? Then what is the advantage of tosyl chloride? Very simple. With the help of tosyl chloride, whatever the sulfonamides we are getting, those sulfonamides are stable crystalline compounds. Stable solid substances are obtaining. Because of that reason, purification of those solids can be easy with the help of crystallization. Purification becomes easy with the help of crystallization process when we are using this tosyl chloride. Okay, right. Now this is about a reaction with the aryl sulfonyl chloride reaction. Then we'll discuss about electrophilic substitution reactions of aromatic amines. Right. Electrophilic substitution reactions of aromatic amines. Electrophilic, of course, important reactions, substitution, electrophilic substitution reactions of aromatic amines. Right, aromatic amines, nothing but aniline, electrophilic substitution reactions. Now we have to discuss. Right, first we'll recall once again aniline structure and as well as its resonance phenomenon. It is aniline, of course. Nitrogen is having a lone pair, and a lone pair as well as a pi electrons are in conjugation to each other. Because of that reason, what happened? Resonance is taking place. Now we'll write the resonance structures carefully. Then this lone pair I am bringing here. Then here this pi electrons will come here. Next structure is like this. Here we will get double bond. NH2, nitrogen is getting plus charge. This we have shifted this here at ortho position, negative charge is accumulating. And next, this bond remains the same. Next, this negative charge is shifted, it is coming here. Upper part remained as it is, NH2 plus. And a new bond is forming, here negative charge accumulating, it is the same. This is going here, it is coming here. Upper part remains the same. Old bond, and here new bond and negative charge. Next, this we are shifting into the ring, it is going back. Again, we will get back the starting structure. Right. Now, if you observe the resonance structures, why you have given all the resonance structures means there is a reason behind that. That is, then if you observe the resonance structures, negative charge is coming at ortho position as well as para position as well as again ortho position only. Negative charge is accumulating only at ortho and para positions. That's it. No meta negative position. Okay. That's why we can say that NH2 group is ortho para director. Sir, what is the meaning of ortho para director? Very simple. That is, I'll give you once again aniline. Just now we have discussed that according to resonance, the negative charges accumulating are though and the para positions. Now we are discussing about electrophilic substitution, electrophile, nothing but electron deficient species. Electron deficient species, where it will come and attack? Definitely electron deficient species need electron rich center. Obviously, it is electron rich center, it is also electron rich center, it is also electron rich center. Means two ortho positions, one para position is electron rich center. Definitely our electrophile will come and attack at particularly ortho and para positions only. That's why NH2 group is called as ortho para director. Why? Because of NH2 group only, negative charges are accumulating at ortho and para positions. Because of negative charges at ortho and para positions, our newly coming electrophile will come and attack at particularly these places. Okay, that's why this is called as ortho para director as well as ring activator. Ring activator means, because of NH2 group, negative charges are present. Because of negative charge, electrophiles can come and attack very easily. That's why this NH2 is activating the ring. That's why it is called a ring activating the group as well as ortho para director. Now, in our electrophilic substitution reactions, if you observe, all electrophilic substitutions takes place particularly at ortho and para positions only. At a meta position, no electrophilic substitution. Why? At a meta position, electron rich center is not existing. That is the reason. Right. Now we'll see one by one all electrophilic substitution reactions of aniline. First, we'll discuss about bromination process. Bromination. Number one. Right, in bromination, what is electrophile? Electrophile is Br plus bromonium ion is an electrophile. Okay, now I'll give you the reaction. When aniline reacting with the bromine water, aniline is reacting with the bromine water, balancing purpose 3 I am writing here. Then what happened? Br plus, from this electrophile generated, Br plus is an electrophile. Electrophile will go and attack particularly ortho and para positions. That's why we will get a compound like this. Two ortho positions and one para position occupied by electrophile, that is Br plus. We will get, its name is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2, 4, 6, tribromo. Tribromo aniline is obtained. 2,4,6 tribromo aniline is obtained. Along with that, byproduct is 3HBr is obtained, of course. Repeat. When aniline reacts with the bromine water, then we will get 2,4,6 tribromo aniline is obtained. Okay. Here, what is electrophile? Electrophile is Br plus bromonium ion is an electrophile. Right. Now, why tri-substitution takes place? Why tri-substitution takes place? Because NH2 group is a highly reactive group. NH2 is a highly reacting group, highly activating group. Up to here there is no problem. Now the important point is, I want to prepare only mono-substituted aniline. Only one bromine should substitute on the benzene ring, not three bromines like this. Mono-substituted aniline purpose. What I have to do? I have to control the reactivity of NH2. I'll repeat. I have to decrease the reactivity of NH2. NH2 reactivity I have to decrease. Then for that purpose, what we have to do? Let's see now. But before that, your first statement is, when aniline reacts with the bromine water, we'll get 2,4,6 tribromo aniline is obtained. Then why tri-substitution is taking place? Because high reactivity of NH2, it is a ring activator. And now what we are doing, we need mono-substituted aniline only. For that purpose, its reactivity we have to control, we have to reduce. For that purpose what we are doing, let's discuss now. Right. First, what I am doing, aniline as is, I am taking aniline And this aniline, instead of bromination, first will do acetylation process. Acetylation. In last class, in last video, we have learned acetylation process. For that purpose, I'll use acetic anhydride. Acetic anhydride I am using for acetylation purpose. Right. Then, just calculated purpose, we'll do one thing. Here, hydrogen will separate and H and CH3COO eliminated as acetic acid. Instead of hydrogen, acetyl group is coming and substituting. We will get one compound, its name is NH. Of course, NH in place of hydrogen, COCH3 is coming and substituting. COCH3. And its name is acetanilide. Acetanilide is forming. Acetanilide. Okay, then question arises here. Sir, why we are doing acetylation? Means our main target is we have to reduce the reactivity of NH2 group. That purpose we have to protect the NH2 group. Then how we are protecting NH2 group? We are protecting NH2 group by doing acetylation process. When acetylation occurs, what is advantage? Advantage is like this. Advantage, let's discuss later. Then whatever the acetanilide is obtained, this acetanilide now reacting with our main reagent bromine. Here bromine water is also not necessary. Bromine and acetic acid only reaction takes place and Br plus generated. Br plus should go and attack at ardo and para. But the advantage, the important point is here instead of ardo, it is preferring at para. Because if it is attacking at ardo, both bulky groups are adjacent to each other, some repulsive forces are existing. Because of that reason, instead of ardo, it is a preferring, electrophile is preferring to attack at para only. Okay, that's why we will get first para bromo acetanilide is obtained. Para bromo acetanilide. But our parent compound is not acetanilide, our parent compound is aniline. Again, we have to get back our aniline. How will you get back? Very simple, doing a hydrolysis. Acidic hydrolysis or alkaline hydrolysis if you do. Because of hydrolysis, what happened? Your bond is breaking. Then we'll get ultimately again aniline product only obtained. Para bromo aniline is obtained. Para bromo aniline or 4 bromo aniline is obtained. Here, how many electrophiles are substituted? Only one. Means it is mono substituted aniline is obtained if you do like this. Then we are doing the protecting NH2 group by doing acetylation. We are getting acetanilide. This acetanilide is reacting with bromine. You will get parabromoacetanilide. This parabromoacetanilide is undergoing acid or alkaline hydrolysis and ultimately we will get 4 bromo aniline. That is a mono substituted aniline is obtained. Then after acetylation we are getting acetanilide. Then acetanilide is, means here if you observe the acetanilide, NHCOCH3 group is not high reactive group like NH2. Okay, this group reactivity is less, its reactivity is not more like NH2. Why means we will write here clearly NH lone pair and CO CH3. If you observe only aniline, here a lone pair is a conjugation with the pi electrons of benzene ring. That's where resonance takes place into the ring only. Only one option. But in case of acetanilide, then it is having two resonance facilities. One is a lone pair and pi bond both are in conjugation to each other. That already known to you. At the same time, lone pair and this pi bond also in conjugation to each other. That's why that resonance takes place this direction also. Not only into the ring, resonance also takes place towards the CO group also. Because of that reason, what happened here? A lone pair availability for resonance decreases. Lone pair availability decreases. Normal aniline, if you take, your availability is more, resonance takes place more extent. But if acetanilide miss is there, definitely your availability decreases for resonance. That's why its reactivity is less comparing with the normal aniline. That's why when NH2 as well as NH2 and NHCOCS3, when we are comparing to each other, NH2 reactivity is more, NHCOCH3 reactivity is less. Because of that reason, we are getting a mono-substituted aniline, that's all. But if you take a normal aniline, then during the bromination process, we are getting a tri-bromo-aniline. Okay, to get a mono-substituted product, we are doing the process like this. Means we are doing the production, we are protecting the group by doing acetylation process. That's all, right. Next, we'll discuss about the second electrophilic substitution, that is a nitration process. Right. What is the nitration? Let's see now. Again, very, very important reaction, nitration process. In nitration, what is electrophile? Electrophile is NO2 plus. Nitronium ion is an electrophile, right? Then we'll discuss about the reaction. When aniline is reacting with a nitrating mixture, because nitration purpose we have to use nitrating mixture. What is nitrating mixture? Nitrating mixture is nothing but it is a mixture of concentrated HNO3 and concentrated H2SO4. Concentrated HNO3 and concentrated H2SO4 mixture is called as nitrating mixture. Right, then when both are reacted to each other, we are getting a nitronium ion electrophile is generated. Then when electrophile generated, what happened? Electrophile should go and attack at ortho and para positions only, because it is ortho para director. Right, let's see what happens. We'll get our expected ortho nitro aniline we are getting. Okay, otherwise we'll write first. I'll write first para nitro aniline and ortho nitro aniline. Both have shown like this. Very, very important point. Please try to understand. NO2 group will go and attack at ortho and para positions only. That's why I will get para nitro aniline as well as ortho-nitro-aniline. There is no doubt up to here. Para-nitro-aniline will get 51%. Then if it is 51%, means obviously we will expect remaining out of 100, 51 means remaining of 49% we are expecting ortho-nitro-aniline. But absolutely it is wrong. Then ortho-nitro-aniline is just 2% only. Remaining 47% unexpected compound is obtained, that is only called metanitroaniline. It is almost 47%. Okay, right, once again, when aniline is undergoing the nitration process, we'll get a corresponding products. What we are expecting generally, our electrophile should go and attack at ortho and para positions only. Right. Here it is attacking at para position, here it is attacking at ortho position, there is no doubt. Then we'll get para nitro aniline as well as ortho nitro aniline. Para nitro aniline is getting 51% only. Ortho nitro aniline is getting only 2% only. Then unexpected product is meta nitro aniline. Is almost 47, means almost para as well as meta almost equally we are getting. Then question arises here, why this phenomena is taking place. Let's discuss first why ortho product is very less. Very simple, here ortho means both bulky groups are adjacent to each other. Because of that reason, what happened? Some repulsions existed between the groups. Because of repulsions among the groups, its stability decreases. That's it. Because of that reason, only 2% of ortho substituted product is obtained. Okay, right. Then why meta is obtained? We'll discuss the reason. See here carefully. Here our nitration mixture, if you observe. It is not only nitration mixture. It also provides acidic medium. It also giving H+ acidic medium. Because of acidic medium, our NH2 is protonated. When NH2 protonated, what happened? NH2 and H2S converted as NH3 plus is obtained. NH2 after protonation from acidic, this nitrating mixture will get NH3 plus. NH3 plus means nitrogen is having plus charge. Then NH3 plus is not orthopara director. NH3 plus is a meta director. It is a ring deactivating group. NH2 is a ring activating group. NH3 plus is a ring deactivating group. It is a meta director. Because of that reason, not only para as well as ortho, meta also getting equally. That is very important. I'll repeat. Why meta substitution is forming? Because nitrating mixture is providing acidic medium. In that acidic medium, our NH2 is protonated. And after protonation, converted as NH3+. NH3+ is a meta directing group. Because of that reason, we are getting a meta also. Therefore, here how to tell the statement? Statement is like this. When aniline is undergoing a reaction with HNO3 as well as H2SO4, we'll get here one more important point is, when aniline is reacting with this mixture, not only these nitro derivatives will also get tarry oxidation products. Tarry means coming. Oxidation products also coming along with this nitro derivatives. Sir, why oxidation derivatives are coming? Because HNO3 is oxidizing agent. Because of that reason also, not only nitro derivatives, some oxidation products also obtained in this reaction. But according to our NCERT book, oxidation products names as well as the structures has not given. Just a statement has mentioned. What they have mentioned? When aniline reacts with the nitrating mixture, tarry oxidation products are obtained. Along with that, nitro derivatives also obtained. What are the nitro derivatives? These three only nitro derivatives. One is para nitro aniline, ortho nitro aniline, meta nitro aniline. Tarry oxidation products. Tarry is nothing but coming. Oxidation products are also coming. But what oxidation products are coming has not mentioned in our NCERT book. That's why no need to worry about that. Just we'll write these products. Right. Now here again one important point. That is, here its availability is 51%, here its availability is only 2% because of repulsions, here its availability is 47%. Now again I want a complete single product, only mono substituted aniline, means maximum percentage, maximum yielded product I want. For that purpose what we have to do then? If you do direct nitration, this is the process. If you do direct nitration, this phenomenon is taking place. Here three products are obtained and all products are not a maximum percentage. It is already almost, it is 50%. That is also nearly 50%. It is very less percentage. Now I need maximum percentage of only single product. I need maximum percentage of only single product. For that purpose, what we have to do? Again, say, next again we'll discuss which is similar to previous case. Here also, again we have to protect NH2 group by doing the acetylation process. Let's see what happens. Now what we are doing, we need only one product which is maximum yield, right? See here, aniline reacts with again acetic anhydride because we are protecting by doing acetylation. As it is a minus CH3COOH, because here H we can separate, this part has eliminated. We will get acetonylate as it is, no change. NH CO CH3. Acetone lead has formed. Now it is not NH2 group. It is NHCOCS group. Right. Now we are doing an iteration process. A reaction with HNO3 and H2SO4. Then previous reaction is not taking place, means here there is no free NH2 group. Sorry. Free NH2 group is not there. That is advantage. Now nitration, if you do, again from this nitration mixture we will get a NO2 plus generated. Where NO2 plus will go and attack? NO2 plus should go and attack at argo and para positions only. But it is not showing interest to attack at argo position because of repulsions between the groups. Because of repulsions. See, if NO2 is attacked here, suppose, then between this group and this group, some repulsions are existed. If repulsions are existed, its stability decreases. That's why it is not showing interest to attack at argo, it will come and attack at para position only. Therefore, you will get a para-nitro acetonylide is obtained. It is acetonylide. Para-nitro acetonylide. But acetonylide is not our parent compound. Aniline is our parent compound. Again, we will get back our compound by doing a hydrolysis process. Acid hydrolysis or base hydrolysis, doesn't matter. And ultimately, we will get a para nitro aniline. One single product only with a maximum yield is obtained. Maximum percentage, only single product is obtained. Its name is both are para to each other. There is a para nitro aniline or 4 nitro aniline also, we can tell. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. This is about nitration process. If you do direct nitration, what is the problem? Problem is, along with argo and para, meta also forming. Why meta forming means, then HNO3 and H2SO4 are providing acidic medium. Because of that reason, NH2 converted as NH3+, which is meta directing group. That's why. And three products are obtained. Along with that, some oxidation products are also obtained. But which oxidation products are obtained has not given in our book. Only nitro derivatives have shown. But what we are doing now, we are protecting NH2 group by doing acetylation process, because we need one single mono substituted product need with high yield. That purpose, we will do this process. Right. Next we will go to third one, sulfonation process. Sulfonation. Let's see what happens. In sulfonation process, what is electrophile? In sulfonation process, electrophile is just SO3, remember. No SO3 plus, no SO3 minus, no SO3H. Just SO3 only electrophile in sulfonation process. Right. We'll discuss about a sulfonation process. When aniline, as usual, is reacting with the sulfuric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid is nothing but H plus and HSO4 minus. And again NH2 and H plus. NH2 H plus will get benzene. NH2 H plus nothing but anilinium. NH3 plus, NH2, H plus, NH3 plus and HSO4 minus. Anilinium hydrogen sulfate is obtained. Anilinium hydrogen sulfate is obtained. And this anilinium hydrogen sulfate is again heated at 453 to 473 Kelvin in the presence of concentrated H2SO4 only. This compound is heated at 453 to 473 Kelvin in the presence of again concentrated sulfuric acid only, then a water molecule eliminated, minus H2O takes place. See, from here hydrogen, then from here oxygen, from here again hydrogen, minus H2O eliminated. After elimination of H2O, then the obtained compound is here only NH2 left. See, once again H, from here one H, from here O, means only NH2 left. And here after elimination of O, we'll have only SO3H is left. Then its name is, that is a para-amino-benzene sulfonic acid. amino benzene sulfonic acid. Of course, para amino benzene sulfonic acid, and its another name is sulfanilic acid. Sulfanilic acid is obtained. Right. Now, what is the advantage of this sulfonic acid? This compound is having both acid as well as base groups. It is acid group, it is base group. In one compound, both acid and base groups are present. Because of that reason, what happened? From acid to base, proton transfer takes place. It is giving a group, it is taking group. Because one is proton donor, proton acceptor. And because of that transfer of proton, we are getting one compound which is like this. NH2 after taking proton becomes NH3+. And SO3H after elimination of proton, loss of proton, SO3- is left. And this compound is having both plus and minus charges. That's why it is called Zwitterion. Zwitterion formation is taking place. That's it. It's about sulfonation process. I'll repeat. When allylene reacts with sulfuric acid, it is a base acid. Nothing but a salt formation is taking place. Anilinium hydrogen sulfate. Again, heated at 453-473 Kelvin in the presence of concentration of water molecule eliminated, and we will get a sulfonylic acid. And a sulfonylic acid contained both acid as well as base groups. Therefore, proton transfer takes place from acid to base group. We will get a Zwitterion. That's it. Next, we'll discuss about another electrophilic substitution reaction, that is Friedel-Crafts reactions. Let's see what happens. Friedel-Crafts reactions. Friedel-Crafts reactions. Right. Why reactions plural we are using? Because it includes Friedel-Crafts alkylation as well as acylation. Let's see what happens when aniline reacts with, suppose if you take Friedel-Crafts alkylation, reacts with alkyl halide in the presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, then we will get a corresponding product. But here the important point is AlCl3 is electron deficient compound which we are using as a catalyst, and this electron deficient compound is a catalyst. Of course, this catalyst should involve in the preparation of or in the production of electrophile. I'll repeat, catalyst should involve in the production of electrophile. But when aniline reacts with alkyl halide in the presence of AlCl3, this AlCl3 is not involving in the preparation of electrophile. Then here AlCl3 being electron deficient, immediately coming and reacting with NH2 group. This catalyst and this reagent both should react actually. But this catalyst being electron deficient, it is not reacting with alkyl halide, it is coming and reacting with NH2 group. When AlCl3 is coming and reacting with NH2 group, what happened? We will get a compound like this. NH2 is nitrogen has given electron pair to AlCl3. It is electron deficient, that's why it is getting plus charge. And nitrogen is getting plus charge. Once nitrogen is getting plus charge, means here there is no any lone pair on it. And if a lone pair is not present, it is not activating group. It is absolutely deactivating group. And here catalyst is not there. Because catalyst coming and reacting here. In the absence of catalyst, electrophile, that is R+, will not generate. That's it. I'll repeat. In the absence of catalyst, alkyl halide is not giving electrophile R+. That's all. Because catalyst is going and reacting with NH2 group. Because of that reason, nitrogen is getting plus charge. Once nitrogen is getting plus charge, it is not an activating group. It is highly deactivating a group. That's it. That's why conclusion is our aniline is not undergoing Friedel-Crafts reactions. That is Friedel-Crafts alkylation as well as acylation process. Right. Next. Actually, our amines lesson includes, okay, amines lesson includes one subtopic also, that is called diazonium salts. Now we have entered into diazonium salts. Nothing but benzene diazonium chloride type salt, right? Now in this topic we have to prepare diazonium salt, and we'll discuss about its properties, right? Generally, how to indicate diazonium salts? Diazonium salts are representing R N2 plus X minus is a representation of diazonium salt. Then here, what R stands for? R stands for aryl group, not alkyl group. Especially in this case, R stands for aryl diazonium salt. Right. Now, here, what is X minus? X minus is nothing but, it may be Cl minus, it may be Br minus, it may be BF4 minus, etc. We'll discuss clearly in this topic then. Then here question arises there. That is, we'll recall once again, when aliphatic amine as well as aromatic amine, then this compound is reacting with the nitrous acid. This compound also reacting with the nitrous acid. Both are reacting with the nitrous acid. Of course, nitrous acid is unstable, will prepare in situ with the help of NaNO2 and HCl. Here also NaNO2 and HCl. Already this reaction we have learned in the previous video. We just go through that video. Now what happened in case of aliphatic primary amine? First we'll get alkyl diazonium salt, but which is most unstable, immediately undergoing hydrolysis, and will get corresponding alcohol as final compound. But as far as aromatic amine, that is aniline, is concerned, will get diazonium salt is obtained, which is stable. Means comparing with this one, it is stable. That's why we did not keep any bracket there. Now question arises here, that is, why it is unstable, why it is stable is big question mark. Why alkyl diazonium chloride, why alkyl diazonium salt is unstable, why aryl diazonium salt is stable? That reason we'll discuss now with the help of resonance structure of diazonium salt. Diazonium ion. See here carefully, why it is unstable, why it is stable. It's the reason we are discussing now. First, we'll understand like this. Bond N2 plus. If N2 plus is there, its meaning is we are having two nitrogens, and between nitrogen and nitrogen, triple bond is there. In that, first nitrogen is having a plus charge, second nitrogen is having lone pair. This you people have to remember. N2 plus means two nitrogens are there. First nitrogen is having plus charge, second nitrogen is having a lone pair. Why it is having plus charge? Because surrounding counter electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, only 4 electrons. Because that is a plus charge. Then there is no any charge, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 out of 5 electrons are there. That's it. Now, why it is stable, we'll discuss by using its resonance structures. Let's see now. Benzene ring. I'll write N2 plus. Now it's the resonance structures we are writing. N2 plus, of course, Cl minus. Cl minus is not having Cl minus, it may be Cl minus, Br minus, any halide. Halide is not having any role in the resonance. Let's say up to here only we are taking, up to this part only we are taking now. Now N2 plus is nothing but N triple bond, N lone pair, here plus charge. Now we can understand its resonance structures very easily. Now what happens, let's see now. Here, because of positive charge in this nitrogen, its electronegativity is more. Immediately, this nitrogen is taking electrons from the ring, that's why this pi bond is shifted from here to here. This pi bond is shifting. Next structure. This bond remains as it is. Now, after shifting, we'll get here a double bond. Then after shifting here, immediately what happened? Nitrogen valence increases. That's why one of the pi bond I am shifting to second nitrogen. I'll repeat. Because of high electronegativity of nitrogen, it is taking electrons from the ring. Therefore, pi electrons are shifted and you will get a new bond. Once a new bond is obtained and one of the pi bond is shifted on second nitrogen. Okay, we will see what happens. Now double bond, nitrogen. Here a triple bond becomes a double bond. And already old one lone pair was there. And after shifting a bond, one more pi bond, another new lone pair is forming. And what about the first nitrogen? First nitrogen charge remains as it is. Why? One bond is coming, one bond is going. One is coming, one is going. There is no any difference. But what about second nitrogen? Second nitrogen, after shifting a pi electrons, it is getting a negative charge. Second nitrogen is getting negative charge. First nitrogen remains same. Because one bond is coming, one bond is going. No difference. Why it is getting negative charge? Because surrounding electrons, if you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, instead of 5, 6 electrons are there. Right. Now, after shifting of pi electrons from here to here, we are getting at ortho position positive charge. Because it is electron withdrawing the group, not a donating group. It is withdrawing electrons, that's why positive charge is forming. Now, this positive charge will be delocalized entire the ring. See here, this pi bond is shifted from here to here. Next structure is like this. Then upper part will write as it is. Two lone pairs, negative charge, plus charge. Then this bond will write as it is. Then after shifting from here to here, you will get a new bond. Plus charge is forming there. Next. Then this pi bond we are shifting from here to here. Upper part N triple double bond N2 lone pairs as it is a minus plus. After shifting from here to here, we will get a plus charge. It is an old bond, here a new bond. And finally, we will get back the starting structure. The negative charge is bringing here, it is coming back. We will get a starting structure. I'll write here. Right, these are the resonance structures of diazonium, benzene diazonium ion, aryl diazonium ion resonance structures we have taken. Then suppose if you take alkyl diazonium, will take R, N, triple bond, N, R plus, R lone pair. Instead of ring, I have taken alkyl group. If you take alkyl diazonium ion, no more resonance. Resonance is not at all possible in case of alkyl diazonium ion. In case of aryl diazonium ion, only resonance is possible. In case of alkyl diazonium ion, no resonance at all. Because of resonance, its stability is more. Because of not availability of resonance, stability is less. That's the reason. That's why alkyl diazonium salts are less stable, because no resonance at all. Why benzene diazonium salts are stable, because resonance is possible. Means this positive charge is delocalized entire the ring. Because of that reason, its stability increases. That's the only reason. Okay, right. Now, we'll discuss its preparation. Benzene diazonium, miss this one. Benzene diazonium chloride, benzene diazonium chloride preparation we'll discuss and then we'll stop today's class. And the thing is, already its preparation known to you. In previous video, we have learned diazotization, same reaction once again we have to write. In previous video, we have learned as a chemical property of amine. Now same reaction we learn as the preparation of a diazonium salt. We'll see that. Diazotization, we'll write once again. Benzene ring, of course, NH2, aniline. Aniline is reacting HNO2, but HNO2 will prepare in situ NaNO2 and HCl at 273 to 283 Kelvin, 0 to 5 degrees centigrade temperature. We'll get benzene diazonium chloride is obtained. along with that NaCl and H2O are obtained. That's it. Benzene diazonium chloride has prepared. This is the only preparation we are having miss for this diazonium salt. When aniline is reacting with nitrous acid HNO2, HNO2 we are preparing in situ. Means instantly during the course of reaction, how? By reaction of NaNO2 and HCl at particularly this temperature, then we will get benzene diazonium chloride. That's it. Okay? Right. And in next class, we'll start its properties. That is physical properties as well as chemical properties. Okay, thank you for watching. Bye.